This video will demonstrate how to measure microcystins as a screening method. Microcystins are a type of toxin that can be produced by certain blue-green algae. The method uses an enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay known as ELISA. There are over 80 variants of microcystins, but the most common is Microcystin-LR. This method is not specific to a particular variant. It measures all microcystin variants, and results are expressed as Microcystin-LR equivalents. Several types of these ELISA kits are commercially available. Prior to analysis, the kits must be removed and allowed to reach room temperature. To measure cell-bound and released microcystins combined, it is important to break the cells before analysis. Breaking the cells can be completed by freezing and thawing, sonicating the samples, or using a lysing reagent. 50 microliters of each standard solution, control, and sample are pipetted into the wells of a test plate, using a new pipette tip for each sample. It is recommended to pipette each sample in duplicate or triplicate to ensure accurate results. All pipette tips should be conditioned as best practice. A plate map should be used to record the position and contents of each well to avoid cross-contamination. The antibody is inverted and poured into a clean tray. 50 microliters of the antibody solution is added to all of the wells using a multi-channel pipette. Pipette tips must be changed if they come into contact with the well contents. Upon addition of the antibody, the wells will be tinted pink. The wells are then covered with parafilm or tape, and the contents are mixed by moving the plate in a circular motion on the benchtop for 30 seconds. The plate is incubated at room temperature for 90 minutes. After the incubation period, the covering is removed and contents of the wells are vigorously shaken into a sink. The wells are then washed 3 times with a multi-channel pipette or wash bottle using the wash buffer solution provided in the kit. The contents of the wells are dumped into a sink between each wash. After the wash, the plate is pat dry on an absorbent surface to ensure all of the wash buffer solution is removed. The enzyme conjugate solution is inverted several times and poured into a clean tray. 100 microliters of enzyme conjugate solution is added to all of the wells using a multi-channel pipette. The wells are covered again with parafilm or tape and mixed by moving the plate in a circular motion on the benchtop for 30 seconds. The plate is incubated at room temperature for 30 minutes. After the incubation period, the covering is again removed and contents are vigorously shaken from the wells into a sink. The wells are washed 3 times using a multi-channel pipette or wash bottle using the wash buffer solution provided. Contents of the wells are dumped into a sink between each wash. Following the wash, the plate is pat dry on an absorbent surface. The substrate solution is inverted several times and poured into a clean tray. This solution is light sensitive and must be protected from direct sunlight. 100 microliters of substrate solution is added into all of the wells using a multi-channel pipette. Upon this addition, you will see the wells tint blue. The samples containing higher levels of toxins will appear clearer than the samples with lower levels of toxins. These will be tinted a brighter blue. The wells are again covered with parafilm or tape and mixed by moving the plate in a circular motion on the benchtop for 30 seconds. The plate is incubated at room temperature for 20 to 30 minutes. The stop solution is inverted several times and poured into a clean tray. 50 microliters of stop solution is added to all of the wells using a multi-channel pipette. Upon addition, the stop solution will tint the wells yellow. The samples containing higher levels of toxins will again appear clear, and the samples with the lower levels of toxins will be tinted a brighter yellow. The plate must be read by the ELISA photometer within 15 minutes of the stop solution being added. The plate is loaded onto the photometer tray and is analyzed when initiated by the software. The tray is read once at 450 nanometers and again at 630 nanometers. Test results can be viewed on the reader software program and are expressed as Microcystin-LR equivalents. All quality control criteria for the analysis and samples must be inspected and met before accepting the test results. If any criteria fail, the run is rejected and must be repeated.